I was going to do the whole thing over again. That's fine though.
Times I've seen you looking up at this wall, I told you you'd make it to the big show. Now here we are, UFC debut right around the corner. All right, UFC promo crew's back here. We're gonna do an interview in a few minutes, but first I need you to fill out this release form. Height, weight, nickname. Bruce Buffer, he's gonna need all of it, right?
Oh, he's right there. Look at that. I'm gonna do a Matt Hughes. Oh, wait. Well, there's Punk. Or, I mean, McGregor. Huh, I'm looking for Punk. What the hell? That's not right. Is that Clay Guida? Oh man, they got everybody, huh? Oh, they have her in the game already. Gotta do it, right? Gotta do the Rousey.
Is you ready for the interview?
Yeah. Actually, before we start, and this is off the record.
Uh-oh.
I just hear there's an interesting story about how you two started working together.
Hey, yo, he wants to hear about your first fight.
I hear it's a good one.
She hates when I tell the story, but I will never forget the first time I met this kid. All right, because she was getting busted up. She looked like a zombie. It was one of those, let's say, amateur cards you can find across town from time to time. Great fights, never know if you're gonna see something special. Right, so yeah, this kid caught my eye.
Look, it's Ronda! Woo!
But it was a total mismatch. It was obvious that the opponent was way more experienced. This kid took a beating for 2 rounds. Okay, probably both 10-8. They could have stopped the fight easy, but the bell sounds to start the 3rd round. And this kid, she's still coming forward. She's still fighting. As if she thought that maybe she had a chance. There was no chance.
Thank you.
So, no surprise, kid loses the fight. Bad. This isn't one of those stories where you find someone amazing out in the middle of nowhere just knocking people out. No. I just found a kid with heart, like I'd never seen, so I reached out.
Good, good. 5 more seconds. Let's go. Work. Work. 3, 2, 1, and time. Beautiful. Hey, look who it is.
Hey.
Welcome to my gym, where champions are made. I could tell from that last fight, you got tons of heart, so I'm not surprised to see you back at it so soon. And you got great physical ability, too.
Thanks.
Now we just got to work on that technique a little bit. All right?
Okay.
Some people think that fighting is simple. Like checkers, but you and I, we know better, right? It's more like chess. You have to have all the right pieces and know how to use them. All right, the masters make it look simple, but it takes hard work and an open mind. I've seen you fight, so I know you got what it takes. Go get ready, come back and meet me here.
All right.
All right, welcome.
Thank you.
All right, let's go, back at it. Get it. Yeah, good. I know this seems pretty basic, you already know this, but I always like to start with boxing fundamentals, right? Because in this game, if you don't know how to throw them hands, put together some combinations, and manage your stamina, you're gonna end up hitting nothing but air and sucking wind.
That's true.
So, listen to my voice, I'm gonna call out some instructions, you follow. Good?
Good.
No.
Let's go.
Huh. All right. I don't wanna do this. I'm gonna go do a tournament
heavy
or something.
And heavy...
Oh, I can skip the tutorial.
Okay, kid, bring it in. Some good work. Now, let's see how that technique holds up against a live sparring partner. Now, here, the name of the game is hit and don't get hit, right? The sweet science. Easy to say, hard to do. So, hands up, use your feet. Let's go.
Okay.
All right, I want to see you kill it today. Let's go in there and crush this. Good work in there. Technique is solid. Amazing what a little coaching can do, right? All right, listen up. I just got a text on another amateur fight card coming up. Now, their opponent's pretty basic brawler, so you will pick her apart with what you just learned. Now, I hope you're ready, because I already said we'd take the fight.
Okay.
You sure?
I'm sure.
You good?
I'm good.
Ah, then let's go. Yo, kid, here we are. Your first real amateur fight. I don't count that last one because you weren't training with me, all right? Remove that from your memory. Your journey starts right here in this parking lot, fighting for no money. But where it ends, sky's the limit, all right? So relax. Yeah, breathe. You put the work in already. Let's go have some fun. You ready?
Ready.
And let's go eat.
Ready? Are you ready? Fight.
Ah!
All right, kid. I know we kept it pretty simple. But if we start mixing in some kicks into your arsenal, then we'll see how dangerous your striking game really is. Use those long limbs to attack the opponent's legs, body, and head. And do it from a distance, controlling the range. Snap from the hips. Keep it loose. Sound good?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. All right, gonna hit some leather today. I'll call it out, you throw. Excellent. High kicks, go. And body kicks, here we go. Okay, new stance now. And change to elbows. Knees now. Here we go. Another one. Let's go. Keep pushing. Keep pushing. Right on target. Excellent. Moving on to the next. Keep at it. Good, good. Bring it in, kid. That was light work for you. Now let's test those moves out in sparring. Now be sure to watch for those kicks coming back at you now, too.
All right.
I think UFC 3 is better.
All right, you ready? I want to see good technique and form this round.
In my opinion.
Excellent blocking. Now focus on blocking all attacks. Awesome job. Now let's move on. Okay, throw some leg kicks. Not bad. All right, land some high kicks now. Good flow. Nice and easy. And give me some body kicks. Go! Okay, now focus on landing combos. More of those. Okay, show me some clinch action. Here we go. Now block everything. Come on, hands up. Keep it tight. Good, good. Don't let her hold you in the clinch. Okay, okay. Looking pretty good. I see some shades of Valentina Shevchenko in there. I like what I see. Listen up. I got a line on another amateur bout coming up. Bit of a step up, an opponent, more well-rounded fighter, but nothing you can't handle if you keep putting in this kind of work. Got it?
Got it.
All right, let's go. Drillers make killers.
All right.
It's a full house tonight. We're looking for a show. So let's go out there and let's give them one. Now, we expanded your arsenal. So let's use all those weapons now. All right? Control the range. Set up your kicks. Use your combinations. Good, good. Yeah, you got this. All right. How you feel?
Good.
All right. Let's go.
Fight. Oh, she's done. Woo. Mm-hmm.
all right, that's good. Bring it in. Now, you probably heard this 1,000 times. Wrestling is the best space for an MMA fighter. Look, I don't know if that's true 100% of the time, but what I do know is that if you're the better wrestler, then you dictate where the fight takes place. You can keep it standing, or you can take it to the ground, and then your opponent has to adapt. Okay, that is the power of wrestling. Got it?
Got it.
All right, you ready to embrace the grind?
Ready.
All right, then let's go. All right, let's get on the mat for some wrestling. Now, we know the ultimate goal is to throw and pin the opponent to the mat, right? Let's go. Work! I want to see some quick sprawls. Let's go! Beautiful combo. Keep at it. All right. Let's see some takedowns. Okay, time for some ground and pound. All right. Let me see you control her on the ground. I love it. She's got nothing against your takedowns. Let's go. Hey, awesome job. Now let's move on. Okay, clinch and give her no room. Get the takedown now. Yes. Awesome. Keep those takedowns coming. Nice work in there. You got some solid technique. But if you ask me, in the end, it all comes down to who wants it more. Right? Which fighter's gonna keep grinding until the other one quits? I know you're not a quitter, and I got you a chance to prove it against another amateur opponent. A decent wrestler, but you got what it takes to win. You got the skills to pay the bills, right?
Yeah.
All right. Great work today.
Thanks.
In the house. Now, don't let that rattle, okay? We're here to work. And if you do what you've done in the gym, everything will fall into place. Relax. Breathe. Good. All right. Keep it loose. Yeah, that's good. Make that kid out of his shoes, shoot that double, put him into the mat. Yeah, then the punishment really starts, right? How you feel? Good?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Okay.
Oh. Don't forget, Dana White.
Dana White.
Thank you.
totally confused on the submission shit. Okay, wait, hold on.
get her? I think I got her. Okay.
Okay, the only part of the MMA game we haven't covered, submissions. All right, I know you've done some rolling before, but look, even if you don't want to learn how to tap people out with chokes and arm bars, you damn sure need to know how to defend against them. Okay, you don't want Herb Dean waking you up in the middle of the octagon, trust me. All right, so we'll start with the basics. Repetition is the mother of all skill. Drill, drill, drill. Got it?
Got it.
Good, let's see it. My clock doesn't stop until you submit her. Let's go. Let's see some BJJ now. Go for the sub. Nice. There, go for the finish. All right, all right, all right. Yes, beautiful work there. Go for the finish. Okay, here we go. Push for some takedowns. Okay, now make sure she can't finish it. Nice work in there. Looks like you've done some of this before. Doesn't matter. All that matters is if you keep putting in this kind of work, your opponent will definitely have to worry about those submissions. That's gonna open up all your other weapons. Total package, right?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Is done. Now it's time to have fun. This is the moment we've been waiting for. You gonna seize it?
Yeah.
Good. Your striking is better than theirs.
Yes.
Your ground game is better than theirs.
Yes.
Your coach is better looking than theirs.
Maybe.
Maybe. Damn.
Come a long way.
Rhonda.
Right, you win this one, you got a shot at the contender series. Then the fun really starts. You hungry?
Yes.
Then let's go.
Wow, yes.
it's over.
Three rounds here. Alright.
Are you ready?
Thank you.
still won it.
Yeah! Come on! Let's go! Let's go!
A pro. Another trophy. Select my fifth one. Finish your training and sign your first career contract.
Alright, let's check this out.
Let's pummel and get that position. Once we're close enough, take down, then control. That was some good work in there. Again, drillers make killers. Beautiful, beautiful. Let's work. All right, 30 seconds left. From bottom. That's the...
Overachiever Trophy. Complete all optional challenges.
DC's World of Pain. You gotta embrace the grind to be a top wrestler. And believe me, we're gonna grind today. Here we go. Come on, let's make her work. You got this. Hey, beautiful defense. Just like that. Come on. Yep, just like that. Nice! Perfect! Come on now, do something with it. 30 seconds, let's go. You dominated today. Good work. Listen, you have to find a way to avoid those takedowns. Okay? Nice work today. That was some good control from the top. From there, you can dictate.
where my money at? What's that money for?
BJJ 101. Find the position, transition, submission. A few more steps in between, but you get the idea. All right, let's push the pace on her. There you go, there you go. Now work on the finish. She won't make it easy for you, so keep pushing those submissions. Nice pass. You got 30 seconds. Let's go. Nice work. Lock her down. Good flow. Hey, we can always get better. Don't worry about it. On.
Next, it's a flyweight showdown between Ashley Evans-Smith and Alexis Davis.
Ready. Ready to fight.
All right, so here we go, as anticipated as any fight on this card tonight. A well-rounded fighter versus the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt.
This fight can go two ways. This can look ugly for the jiu-jitsu fighter. She could be forced to stand. She's in a lot of trouble. She needs to take this fight to the ground as soon as she can in order to win the fight.
And with conviction, she moves right into half guard.
Without much effort, she was able to pass from her full guard right into half guard.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Davis is going for the sub here.
Gotta be careful, Alvar.
Nicely done. Just over 3 minutes now to go. All right, so the ground and pound strikes continue to land. She's not staying busy for the sake of it. She is doling out damage.
She's landing a lot of punishing ground and pound. And this is gonna really zap her opponent as they get back to the feet.
When you get in a bad spot on the ground and you wanna reverse it, that's what you need to do.
Masterclass in changing position, unreal to see.
Oh, and with conviction, she moves right into half guard.
Without much effort, she was able to pass from her full guard right into half guard.
Oh, how about that reversal by her there, champ?
That is a fantastic transition by this young lady. What a job.
Great movement by her here on the ground, and she just does it so fluidly and so easily. It's really a sight to behold.
You can tell that she's been a lifetime developing the skill with the way that she's able to move with so little effort on the mat.
Now trying to trap an arm. guard position for her here. And if you're the bottom fighter, this is truly a case of pick your poison.
Yeah, you got to pick your poison. And if you're on the bottom, you got to be trying to find a way to escape that bottom leg. You cannot allow your opponent, you cannot allow her to sit on your leg and just throw big damaging strikes. You got to make sure you're on an elbow control, an underhook, and getting back to your feet.
Final seconds. That knee might have landed there. Round two, straight ahead. All right, DC, here we go with our next round, and shout out to the Diaz brothers and everybody watching in the 209, because it looked like the Diaz sister there in that previous round. A lot of volume, a lot of accuracy on
her. She took that same type of approach. I will set a pace that you are not able to keep up with. I will put my hands on you over and over again. I'm not going to hit you hard every time, but I'm going to keep touching you until eventually you're going to melt in front of me.
Trying to get a triangle here.
Oh, nice. Now she's in trouble.
The sheer will is really remarkable to watch. She's got side control now. Maybe some of those knee strikes to the body. A lot of different things available to her here.
Now, in the side control, you may feel like the bottom person that you have a lot of out, but there is a lot of danger in those positions too. A lot of danger in the knees coming your way. A lot of danger in the chokes. So you have out, but you're also constantly under duress from a great top fighter.
In full guard now, DC, and I know when you're in this position, you're looking to pass the half guard pretty quick.
Oh, absolutely. Trying to get the half guard so I can start to get off ground and pound. This is exactly what she needs to do. Not only does it get you to a position to get off ground and pound, it also takes a lot of the...
Davis is trying to get a triangle submission here.
Oh!
And this might just be a matter of time. In the fight. All right, right into side control now. We'll see if she can dole out some damage. A lot of fighters would prefer the half guard. She does pretty good work here.
She does great work in the half guard. She's very brutal. She's very heavy with her top half. So she doesn't worry about the opponent escaping. And this side control is very good for her because she wants to wear on you. She wants you to try to carry all of her weight with your upper body and make a mistake that will lead to a fight-ending finish for her.
Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement on the ground.
She looks like a master of grappling with the great movement that she's showing on the ground.
30 seconds now to go on the round. All right, so her ground control is outstanding. Half guard is when she's at her most dangerous.
Yeah, she's at her most dangerous when she has a half guard because she's so brutal with the ground and pound. She likes to go after fighters and really wear on them, force them to make...
You ready to fight? Ready.
Third round underway.
Big kick lands.
Able to check the high kick.
Another clinch position.
Oh, the right hand is there for her. Stuffs the takedown, no problem. Oh, she landed another strike to the body there. Very smart to work that body late in the fight when her opponent is fatigued. You didn't see... Hey, there it is, her first takedown of the fight. She told us in our fighter meeting Thursday, at some point I will take... Well, she's got the head trapped here, might be trying to set up a guillotine choke.
Right in the side control, yep.
Well, she was long on grappling experience coming into the UFC, and you see her chops here, just beautiful when it comes to the transition.
It's very difficult to keep up with her on the ground.
So under 3 minutes to go here in the fight. Man, she is just nonstop on the ground, moving in all...